Well, passwords suck for a bunch of reasons.
One of our founders said when he started NEA, we finance change.
I really enjoy deep tech, hard tech work. I think maybe as people will think about it as kind of classic venture capital, go work on really hard problems.
Well, first of all, you have to decide what change is. That's the tricky part. When you see something that you think is, in fact, might change the world, that's when you want to invest.
Well, passwords suck for a bunch of reasons. And, you know, the one that seems most apparent to people is, well, humans aren't very creative. And even though you think you thought of a unique password, somebody else thought of it before. And so it's easy to remember all of those. And of course, if you really should have a different one for every site, and it's good luck with that.
You know, I've known Jim for a long time. We worked together at Stanford. And he came to me quite a few months ago with his new idea, which is how can we deal with passwords and how can we deal with all the problems that they create?
They're supposed to be a secret. It's something that I know. And yet all the systems around passwords have me telling someone what my password is. How is it that I have a secret and I keep sharing it?
It was a problem, and Jim had a very innovative solution.
When I first saw Beyond Identity, it was like, yes, at last. You know, I think for having seen sort of the promise of really using public key infrastructure and ideas, that it felt like, well, yeah, we are going to move to a world where each person is going to have a private key and you'll have a public key, and we'll both authenticate ourselves as well as secure communications through those sign things. And that hasn't happened for a lot of reasons. And seeing Beyond Identity come in and do this exceptionally clever, simple thing, it was at last.
The solutions that are out there are really about just managing the various identities that people and objects and systems have. Protecting the identity is a harder problem.
The thing that's changed now is I have these devices. I carry around these smartphones. At last, we have a way of me storing my private key with something that I keep with me all the time.
So Jim came up with the idea of using that hardware to eliminate passwords, and using the mechanisms that he had developed earlier as part of Netscape to pile on top of the biometrics and together come up with a scheme that meant that you didn't need passwords.
When you look at taking on essentially a multi-billion-dollar market like identity management with a new idea, it really better be good, and it has to be disruptive, so it really has to be easy.
The breakthrough was figuring out that you could couple those two things together, that you could have the kind of public key, private key cryptography together with biometrics, together with the hardware mechanisms on smartphones, and all three of those things together, suddenly you don't need passwords. But you had full biometric security. It's really novel and immediately, obviously, very powerful.
This is the team that you really want working on this problem, because it's the intersection of really smart people who actually, many of them, in the formation of the network protocols, things like TLS, that have built upon the public key systems, but also people who know what it means to make something that people really will use and interact with. In addition to be like really clever, and I'm going to be my own certificate authority, I can do that, and a consumer doesn't have to know how to spell CA. We're going to have to describe to our grandkids what a password is.